हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सुमैया इंग्लिश प्राइमरी स्कूल क्लास सिक्स एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज़ इंग्लिश ग्रामर. द चैप्टर इज 19 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द प्रोग्रेसिव टेंसेस. वी विल सी द चैप्टर टू चैप्टर या 19 एंड 21st वी विल सी द 19th चैप्टर. नाउ वी विल सी व्हाट इज प्रोग्रेसिव वर्ब टेंस. इन दिस प्रोग्रेसिव टेंसेस इट शोड दैट the action is still in the progress at the time of speaking. So to form the progressive tenses, we need to combine the verb with the verb in the present by adding ing to the verb. For example, we can see the word here, working. That means we have added the ing. In this we can see the progressive is all the three tenses, in all the three tenses. That means in the present tense of verb we can use is, are, am, and in the past tense of verb we can use was and were. So this was the progressive tenses. Now in the progressive verb tenses there are three types of tenses, that is the present progressive tense, past progressive tense and the future progressive tense. So first we will see what is present progressive tense. In this tense it shows an action that it is in progress, now at the present form. Before adding the ing verb we should add the present form, that is to be. So now the second one is the past progressive tense. In this tense it shows that an action is in progress in the past. Here also before adding ing we should add the past form in the sentence. Now the third one is the future progressive tense. In this tense it means future, that it shows an action that will be in the progress. So here we will see the example of the progressive verb tense. See the three parts is the, that is the past, present and the future. Here in the three example I was working on my book report. See the working is a progressive verb tense which we have added the ing, and before that we have added the past thing, that is the was. Progressive verb tense shows action that is, was or will be in the progress, happening at some point in time. So before adding ing we have to add the verb. So in the next example also we can see I am designing a roller coaster for the science. That means designing, here also the word added the ing. Before the word ing, that is a designing word, we have added am. That is I am designing, that is it is in the present progressive verb tense. Here also we have added the verb before adding the ing. Now the third example is I will be eating lunch at Dana's house tonight. So this sentence go to the future progressive verb tense. Here also the word eating is there. In the eating the ing word is added. Before eating we have added the helping verb, that is the verb we have added, that is a will be, which shows the proper future progressive verb tense. So this was the example. Now the next chapter we will see the verbs, the perfect tense. So now the topic is the perfect tense. It means the complete tense, means it gives the proper finished sentence, because it indicates an action that it is finished. Then it knows the perfect tense. In this tense it focus on the present even if it is in the past event. Here the simple things you have to remember, in the perfect tense it shows, that means it shows us the past event also, but we have to focus on the present tense, that is a present one. So first we will see here, in the perfect tense there are the three parts, that is past perfect tense, present perfect tense and the future perfect tense. So in the perfect tense, it shows an action is in the past, present or future, we will see. So first one is the present perfect tense. In this tense, it connects with the past action to the present action. That means in this tense, that is a present perfect tense, it connects with the past one. Here we can see the example. By the example, you can understand very easily. The first one is the I have lost keys. I cannot open the door. That means I have lost keys. Have lost means it goes in the past things. That means it is connected with the past action. It is a past action. I cannot open the door. The action was happened past, but the sentences it gives the present time. Now we are talking that I can't open my door now because I have lost my keys. So here the action is the past action, it is shown. But we have to focus on the present one. Mary has gone out. She is not home now. The both the thing is very clearly it is shown. Has gone means she went out. Has gone, that is a past action. So that's why she is not home now. Now means it indicates the present time. An action that started in the past and still happening. That means whatever the action we have seen in the sentences, it is in the past one. But it is still happening. We have not been to New York. That means my mother has been sick for many years. Means we have not went till New York. And the second one is my mother is still sick for many years. Means from the so many years she was sick. But still now also she is sick only. So now the next one is the past perfect tense. In this tense, the past perfect takes place before the another past action. Before the another past action. Here also we can see the example. I noticed that he had left his books behind. That means the notice verb shows the past action. That means he or she has seen the books that has been left it behind. Had left, the word gives the past perfect here. That means after giving the past perfect, that sentence goes to the complete sentences. So we have to remember in everywhere, that means it shows the past action. With the past action, it indicates the perfect tenses. So now the last one is the future perfect tense. In this tense, it is only used for a few situations. It is also fact here. In the future perfect tense, it is only used in a few situations. That means in this future perfect, there are two elements. First element is the we have to add to have. That means will have. The simple future of the verb is the word to have. Or the will have. You can see the example here, picture is given. And next is the two elements. The another element is the past participle. That means we can see the example. He will have finished. Will have will be the simple future of the verb. And the finished comes the word past participle. So always we have to remember in the future perfect tense there are two elements. In that two elements, the first one is the full in the whole sentences. The first it shows the subject and then we are adding the will have. Will have word indicates the future perfect tense. And the next main verb we are added, that is a finished here. I hope so all the points are clear. Thank you.